A man has been bashed and then his home shot at in a terrifying road rage attack on the Gold Coast.
Amber Austin Wright joins us now live. And Amber, what's the latest on the victim's condition?
Matt, we spoke to the victim this afternoon and he says he's been traumatised by what happened. He didn't go into detail about how the road rage incident started, but he has certainly ended up battered and bruised in this terrifying ordeal.
Bullets fired at a ute and into the front door of a house. This is road rage at the extreme. The attack started at a nearby service road but finished at the victim's home.
Got followed home and shotgun shots in my ute and in the front door of my house. Yeah, everyone's pretty traumatised here at the moment.
The 22-year-old, known only as Mitchell, suffered a cut to his eye and chipped teeth after he was bashed by three men in another car. His female passenger witnessed it all, but neither realised they'd been followed.
Not really. I can't remember anything after a good 10 or so blows to the head.
Less than 2 hours after the first attack came the second.
I think it was the third or the fourth gunshot. The car drove off in a hurry.
A group of friends had been inside visiting.
Definitely it could have been worse, and I'm just glad that it wasn't.
The victim says he doesn't know his attackers and he won't be sticking around to see if they return. He plans to move out of the home as soon as possible.
It's the fifth shooting on the Gold Coast in as many weeks, and it's taking a toll on residents.
It's just getting out of hand now. It's just ridiculous.
A lot of young families. The kindergarten right next door, so you don't need that sort of thing around here.
The victim says he would react differently in a similar situation.
I can just suggest keep driving. If you have any road rage issues, don't pull over.
Police have set up a major incident room to investigate.
A man was seen leaving the property in a white Toyota Hilux shortly after the shooting. Police are appealing for any witnesses to come forward.
Thank you, Amber Austin-Wright, reporting there.